The majority of systems today depend upon signatures based on malware hashes to detect an attempt to infiltrate malware. Signatures are effective in detecting much of what's already known and for investigating the extent of a known intrusion. An indicator of compromise, or IOC, is essentially a more advanced malware signature and may be one or more of an MD5 hash, a command and control domain name, or a known malicious IP address, a file or registry key associated with known malware, and so on. IOCs allow a particular threat to be documented in a consistent fashion and to facilitate automated sharing of actionable threat information. To be effective, they need to be timely, relevant, accurate, specific, and actionable. The lifecycle of an IOC can be seen in this graphic. When a compromise due to malware occurs, an investigation takes place and data is collected to determine what's happened and how it's happened. This provides much valuable information about the way the malware works. The data can be analysed and IOCs created. These can then be deployed to intrusion prevention systems to ensure the same compromise doesn't happen again. Sharing IOCs is of real value to organisations that haven't yet been attacked, because they can use them to avoid attack. Fortunately, this is possible with sources such as the IOC Bucket. IOC Bucket is a free-to-use, community-driven platform which allows sharing of threat intelligence in a simple but efficient way. IOCs are developed by the community, reviewed by the community, and distributed for use by the community. When I press search, we can see that this is as yet still an early start with only 559 IOCs in the database. If we click Tools, Open IOC Online Editor, we get a screen which allows a manual entry of an IOC. This shows the kind of information held in the database. A range of items can be included and built using AND and OR expressions to form the IOC. These include specific parts of cookies, emails, URLs, files, and so on. If we click on Email, we can see the email items we can select. I'll select Body Text, and so now I can enter a value. IOC Bucket is a great initiative which should become a mainstream source of IOCs over time. While adversaries constantly change and adapt malware, they tend to use the same tools and techniques and procedures in the malware. Process injection, credential dumping, token stealing, host enumeration approaches, and so on. By developing ways to detect these indicators and add them to the standard IOC checks, the success rate for detecting malware will be significantly enhanced. Stixx and Taxi are two interacting standards designed to support automated sharing of threat intelligence. Stixx defines the threat intelligence, while Taxi defines how that information is communicated. Associated with Stixx Taxi is the set of standardized cyber observables, which can be used to build IOC expressions. These include such things as domain names, email and IP addresses, file extensions, and so on. Stixx Taxi is a community project coordinated by the OASIS Cyber Threat Intelligence Technical Committee. Stixx Taxi version 2 specifications have now been published and are in active use globally. The Stixx 2 architecture focuses on adversaries and TTPs and provides a rich form of expression for relationships between the various objects making up the Stixx object. The model includes objects which describe information relating to observations, sightings, incidents and campaigns, attack patterns, tactics, techniques and procedures, victims and threat actors. With the prevalence of poly and metamorphic malware, amongst other challenges, signatures and IOCs are insufficient for the level of malware detection and prevention needed nowadays to prevent compromise. Unlike IOCs, an indicator of attack, or IOA, focuses on detecting the methods and intent of what an attacker is trying to accomplish, regardless of the malware or exploit used in the attack. This includes detecting hard problems for traditional defences, such as intrusions into systems using legitimate but stolen credentials, and detecting software which has the characteristics of zero-day exploits. IOAs are often linked to the cyber kill chain, the set of steps an attacker will take, starting with basic reconnaissance. IOAs can be used to monitor for signs of an attack at many of these kill chain stages. Azeria Labs provide a useful diagram explaining the development of sophisticated detection techniques from basic signatures with hash values to IOCs based on IP addresses, domain names, and so on, through to the most advanced approach using TTPs. Cyber hunting, to check for the presence, currently or in the past, of intrusions, is essentially a manual form of detecting indicators of attack. While there has been a lot of attention placed on cyber hunting, the reality is that cyber hunting manually can be very difficult to do effectively, and it won't scale. However, by combining cyber hunting methodologies with automation, analytics, and artificial intelligence, intrusions can be detected at speed and at scale. These kind of products are starting to emerge, with Darktrace being an early example.